Manti Te'o.
Manti Te'o is the linebacker who put the fight back in the Irish, leading himself and his team to national prominence this past season. And his efforts were burnished by a parallel narrative of pain and perseverance. Fans rallied to support Te'o, who disclosed that his grandmother and girlfriend had both died on the same day in September. As he told it, his girlfriend, Lene Kekua, was a victim of not only a car accident, but also leukemia.
You know, that feeling of loss.
Her death, the end of a long-distance, mostly online or over-the-phone romance. Few, if anyone, thought it odd that the two had supposedly never met in person.
Possibly the most beautiful girl I've ever met. Not because of her physical beauty, but the beauty of her character and who she is.
The news media were quick to consume the story.
On the day his girlfriend was buried, he knelt on the field to pray.
But then came the national championship game on January 7th.
Manti Te'o and the rest of his defense unable to wrap him up.
Te'o was awful in the loss to Alabama. And we learned last week one possible reason. That leads us to Deadspin, a sports blog which had done some checking on Te'o and his love story. Jack Dickey helped write the report, which appeared on Wednesday.
Well, okay. 22-year-old Stanford grad gets in a near-fatal car accident, contracts leukemia, and then dies. That's a big tragedy. That's going to be written up somewhere. It wasn't. There was no death notice, no obituary, no announcement of her funeral.
Checking further, Deadspin found the photos of Lene Kekua were of someone else who was very much alive and unfamiliar with Manti Te'o, around whom suspicion now swirled.
I think it's highly unlikely that he was duped in the fashion he says he was.
How many of you are here tonight with your imaginary girlfriends? How many?
Notre Dame tried to explain. Athletic director Jack Swarbrick said the triumph over tragedy narrative began to unravel when Te'o was called on December 6th by someone who said Lene Kekua not only had not died, but it actually never existed. But here's the thing. Te'o did not tell Notre Dame for 20 more days and continued to speak publicly of a girlfriend who died.
I don't like cancer at all. You know, cancer, I lost both my grandparents and my girlfriend to cancer, so.
He says now he was confused. Notre Dame was chagrined.
This was a very elaborate, very sophisticated hoax perpetrated for reasons we can't fully understand, but had a certain cruelty at its core.
On Wednesday, Te'o released a statement that the whole episode was incredibly embarrassing. And Friday night, he told ESPN some Samoan man had confessed to pranking him. Te'o flatly denied he was in on some weird scam. But so far, weird is the best word for this evolving story. One that was simply too good to be true.